Okay, in this video we're going to talk about logging in and managing members. So we're going to be working off the live or the production server, and the URL for that is eduprod.usm.edu/user. What you're going to be doing is putting in your empl ID, your W and that six-digit number, and you're going to be putting in your SOAR password, and that's how Drupal recognizes you and logs you in. When you're in, you'll see a link or links to any group or groups that you have access to. So in this case, we're going to be working off testing group 2. And again, I'm pretending to be a group admin in the system, so I see exactly what you guys will see as group admins. And a quick point, once I'm logged in, I've actually got a logout button down here, or I could simply go up into the URL and type in logout and execute that, and that will take me out of the system. Okay, so depending on where you're working or if there are potential security issues, you might want to, log out periodically. Okay, and Drupal's not going to time you out. Now, as far as adding members, when you're at this sort of landing page for your group, you'll see content options that you can create as a group admin, and you also see this members link. We're going to click on that, and we've got two members in this group already. One of them is myself as an admin who set this up. The other is this group admin that I'm pretending to be right now. Okay, and you can see there's a remove membership option, which we can remove anybody at any point from your group, and you can do that as admins. So if somebody leaves the office or department, if it's a student who graduates and moves on, you simply click on remove membership, confirm that, and they're gone. If somebody is an admin and you want to change their status to an author, you would simply click on admin remove and change that status, or confirm that change in order to change the status. If we want to add new members, now I know I've got somebody in the system here, and I'm just going to grab her empl ID. And the key point here is that if someone hasn't been to that /user login page and logged in with their empl ID, you can't add them in any type of role for the group. Drupal has to recognize and acknowledge their ID. Okay, so and you can comma separate this and add as many users at one time as you want, as long as they've logged in. So you simply click on the Add Users button. You'll get a dialog box that pops up and confirms that that person's added. You'll go back to the list view. You'll see again that she's not an admin. But if I click on Admin Create, this is simply a toggle between Remove and Create. I confirm that status, that I want her to be an admin, and I go back and look at the list view. Boom, she's an admin. And that changes to an admin remove, again, with the option to take that that level of access away. So that's pretty much it in terms of managing members. We'll move on to the next one.